Hey guys, welcome back. These are two, the next two are box sets and they're pawn shop buys that I picked up, of course, at the pawn shop. And this is a show that I actually, you know, I have not seen much of the show, but at the time that I did see it, I turned the TV and I got engrossed in the show. Well, not, maybe not engrossed, that's too strong a word, but I watched the show and I liked it. I'm a fan of William Shatner and James Spader. And they both star in this TV series, and I thought, you know, this is definitely not really a show that I normally just watch, but this was a pretty damn good show. But this is season one of Boston Legal, and like I said, guys, from what I've seen of the show, I really enjoyed Boston Legal. I thought it was a really enjoyable show, a lot of fun, and I had a good time with it. There's the back of it. But apparently this is three discs, or maybe there's more than three in here. But they, like this, guys. Is that Candace Bergman? I think so. James Spader. And William Shatner. See how they look inside. Yeah, there's one disc inside, guys. But yeah, from what I've seen of Boston Legal, though, guys, I liked it. I thought it was a lot of fun. Let's put these in order. But you know, the best thing about this set, guys, is that how much do you think I paid for it? Take a guess while I put this up. I paid a measly $3 for Boston Legal, guys. Three measly dollars. There you go. You can see it now. $3 for 17 episodes, so you know that's a damn good price. Then of course they had season 2, which the first season has 3 discs. This season has 1, 2, 3, 4 discs. And it was $3 as well. So you definitely cannot beat that, guys. Season 2. Now I may have to get the rest of them, which I think I will, because I think they're pretty cheap on Amazon. Some of the discs, guys. But yeah, I'm really I had no plans to buy Boston Legal, but when I saw it, $6 for 2 seasons, I mean, I couldn't pass that up. And all the discs are in pretty good shape. Next, guys, we have some Best Buys. Best Buys. But these are all actually box sets that I bought. Not counting what I bought for my fiance. She's a big Roseanne Barr fan. Roseanne show. She really loves that show. So I bought her the complete Roseanne show, which is like 200 and something episodes. Which I like Roseanne, but I'm not a big fan of it as she is. But you won't be seeing that one because she's put that up in her collection. But this is one that I seen very little of this show when it premiered. And I'm really, really glad to have this. It only costs like $14.99, but this is a very rare show. A very rare presentation that features one of the greatest comedians of all time, in my humble opinion. And that, of course, is Richard Pryor, and this is the Richard Pryor Show. And I don't really have very, very good memories of this show, guys. There's the back of it. If you can see it too good there. But this was actually put out by NBC, and it was on primetime television. And NBC kind of coached Richard Pryor, persuaded him to do the show. And Pryor really was really leery about doing the Richard Pryor Show because, first off, he thought, you know, my comedy is not suited for television. And if any of you know Richard Pryor, you probably know exactly what I mean. But given the kind of comedy what Pryor was used to doing, NBC wanted him, hell, well, why don't you give it a shot and see what happens? We'll give you 10 episodes to do for the season. See if you like it. And Pryor had the wisdom to know that, you know, this isn't going to work. I can't. It's just not how I do comedy. So he talked NBC into trying 4 episodes. So he said, yeah, why don't we just cut that 10 down to 4? Let me do 4 and we'll see what happens. But unfortunately, what happened was that Pryor ended up doing the show, those four episodes, and the NBC censors were so on his ass because he just couldn't do what he wanted to do that he finally, you know, threw in the towel. And what I remember about the show is that one final episode he did, and maybe my memory is a little bit flaky, but from what I can remember, I remember watching the show. Pryor was on television, and he came out with a little sign over his genitalia area, a little white sign, and he said, I'm not sure about this, but it's something like, this is my last show, this isn't working out. But, you know, I'm tired of dealing with the NBC censors. I can't do what I wanted to do. And that's why I'm out here now, because of the censors. And he removed the paper and they put a big box over it. I don't even think NBC was expecting what they got there. But that was the end of the show. And that was Pryor's way of going out. You know, his same unique style of, fuck you, I'm going to do what I want to do. And that's how Richard Pryor lived his life. He did what he wanted to do. He lived fast and he died hard. But, I can't wait to give the Richard Pryor show a look again, guys, because I don't remember much about this show at all. As a matter of fact, let's see who was on this show. Does it have any of the stars that was on it? The Richard Pryor Show cast includes Sandra Bernhard, I don't know her. Tim Reed, I know. Marsha Warfield, I know. Robin Williams. That was the main cast of this show. Robin Williams was on this. The Richard Pryor Special, special guest stars John Belushi, guest star Maya Angelou, I don't know who that is, Sandra Bernhard, LaWanda Page, Aunt Esther herself, cool, Tim Reed, Marsha Warfield, and that's it. Three episodes, or three discs there, guys, the Richard Pryor Show. Definitely gonna give that a look. Do you guys hear my phone? What did I get? Oh, it looks like a bit strip update. Don't you just hate when you get invites to play games on Facebook? It sucks, really. Let's see what else I got. Yeah, that's me. There I am, guys. Looking all sharp as the captain of the USS Valiant. But anyway, thought I'd give it a plug there, guys. Next, we have another film series that I like. Ooh, weird colors. Wow, this looks weird. Oh, it's back to normal now. But this is another complete series of films or television series that I like. And I'm not sure how many episodes this ran for. And I really can't see it on here, and I'm not going to break my back trying to find out. We'll save that for a DVD and Blu-ray box set review. But this is a series that I enjoyed as a kid. Loved the series. Had a lot of fun with it. But this is the complete series of The Addams Family, the original series. Like I said, a fan of this show, guys. Enjoyed it as a kid and had a lot of fun with it. There's the back of it there. The Addams there themselves. But I like the Addams Family. Good time with this show, guys. Put out by MGM DVD, which is probably a pretty good job they did on it. Yeah, plenty of special features as well. Good. Out of space. Then finally in the collection, guys, I got the complete series of a show that probably growing up was one of my favorite shows on television. This came out a lot earlier than I was around. As a matter of fact, I caught it in the syndication. But this is a show that to this day is still running, just like the Addams Family. And I love this show. I love the cast. These people in this show are probably some of the most recognizable people in television. And I'm just really, really giddy to have the complete series of this show. And I can't wait to watch it from start to end. But this is the complete series collection of Gilligan's Island. And like I said, guys, I'm a big Gilligan's Island fan. I've always loved this show. It's one of my favorite shows to catch in the afternoon after school. This is pretty doggone heavy, too. But there's the back of it, guys. Now I have more movies to find space for. But that's my collection haul for today, guys. I got quite a bit of stuff, and definitely glad to have each and every one in my collection. Like I said, guys, this is a shameless plug here. I am working. I haven't been putting out a whole lot of videos. I know, guys, you guys are aware. This last B-Movie Mania episode featuring Gallo Walkers, I've done that, and that came like 2 weeks after the last video that I made. But been busy with work, and been quite a bit busy with the Star Trek fan film. And I'm going to make a video letting you guys know where we are on that fan film. But if you're a fan of mine, guys, and you're on Facebook and you haven't done this yet, please go to Facebook, type in Starship Valiant in the search engine, and look up my fan film and give me a like and show me some support. Send me a message. Let me know where you came from. But I really appreciate that, guys, because we need all the fan support we can get to get this thing made. And, you know, the more support we have, it opens up the doors of possibly, you know, someone looking at the production and saying, hey, these guys, a lot of people like this. Because, you know, it does happen. We had a guy who was gracious enough to buy over half of the cast uniforms. And, you know, that's once you put that into numbers, guys, that's about $800 to $900. So, you know, and he's only doing it simply because he loves the production and he loves Star Trek. So if you get a chance, guys, please take a look and let me know what you think. And as a special little deal here, guys, I'm going to show you for the first time it's ever been around. I'm going to show you a clip from what we're working on. See you guys later. Take care and thank you.
I want to thank you personally, sir. Your recommendation got me onto the Ajax.
It was the least I could do. They'll have a great addition to their crew.
Thank you, sir. And best of luck to you.
Ensign Torres.
Yes, sir.
I'm sorry about Lieutenant Taylor. He was a good man.
Thank you, sir. So close to getting married. It's been an honor, sir. You brought us home.
The honor was all mine. Here's to you, Captain. And all those hands that fail.